Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's talk about managing the photos on your iPhone. Now, I get a lot of questions from people about photos on their iPhone. They want to get some photos onto their iPhone, or they want to get photos off of their iPhone, or they don't understand why they have too many or too few photos. It's important to understand the difference between the camera roll, which is photos that you've taken on your iPhone, and the photo library, which are photos that you've synced from your Mac or PC to your iPhone. And there's many different ways to manage these two areas where photos are kept. But here's a method I think will work for most people to get them what they want. Now here's what you might find on a typical iPhone. If you go into the Photos app, you can see that there's a camera roll, and that's it. You go into the camera roll and you can find photos that you took using this iPhone, which also includes screenshots. But here's a bunch of photos that were taken on this iPhone, and that's it. Now the first thing you want to do is get these photos from your iPhone to your Mac or PC. It's important to treat your iPhone just like you would a digital camera. You have photos on it, you want to get those photos into your photo library, which typically for a Mac user would be using iPhoto. So I've connected my iPhone to my Mac, and now in iPhoto here, if I go on the left, I can see under Devices there's the iPhone, and I can see here are the photos that I've got, the same ones that I was looking at before on the phone itself, and you can see I just could simply import those 13 photos. So I'm going to do that. Now when it's done, I get to choose whether or not I get to delete these photos or keep the photos. Now deleting them simply removes them from the camera roll. It's just like when you have a digital camera and you've taken some photos, now you want to clear the camera's memory off because you've copied all those photos to your Mac. So typically you do want to delete those photos, and then we'll look at how to get some of the photos that you want to have with you back onto your iPhone. So now in iPhoto here, I can go and look at the last import, which I have selected, or I can go into my events and find what I imported. Typically, things will be in a single event. Here I've got a lot of photos taken over a long period of time, so they're all put in their own events right here. And you can see all these different photos. In addition to that, if I go to my events, I can see I have all sorts of events here from photos that I've taken over the years. So there's not just the new ones, but also a lot of old ones. Now I want to create a way to get these photos back onto my iPhone, just the ones that I want. Now some people may love the idea of taking all their photos to get into the iPhone, but I just want to take a select few that I want to have carry around with me. Maybe pictures of my child, pictures of family, pictures of my most recent vacation, things like that. So the easiest way to do that is to create a new album. So I'm going to create a new album here, and I'm just going to call it For iPhone. And then I'm going to go into my photos here and drag and drop photos that I want into this album. And I'm just creating basically like an album, like a playlist for iTunes, or just a list of links to these photos. I'm not actually moving them from the events. Of course, when I create an album, I'm just creating an easier way to view these. So I put a whole bunch of them in here, and if I view this album now, I can see those photos. So those are the ones I want to carry around with me on my iPhone. So the next step is I want to go into iTunes. iTunes is how I sync things between my phone and my Mac. So under iTunes, I want to select my device, my iPhone right there in the left. Now if you don't have your left sidebar turned on, you can turn that on by choosing View, Show and Hide Sidebar, and then you can easily see it. If you do have the sidebar hidden, then it actually would appear just over on the right here. You can see your iPhone or a list of devices. I'm going to do it easier and show sidebar here in iTunes 11 so I can select my iPhone. And now you can see one of the tabs here is Photos. And here's where I can choose which photos to sync. I'm going to say yes, I do want to sync photos. I want to do it from iPhoto. And I can say All, which will fill the iPhone with photos. But I just want to go and say Selected Albums, and I can look at the albums here and see there's For iPhone. Now you can see I can have multiple albums, so I can create an album of like family pictures, vacation pictures, things like that, and select several of those albums to sync over to my iPhone. So for instance, I'm going to also select the Scenery album that was there previously and have these two albums sync over to the iPhone. And once I have figured all that out, I can hit Apply. Now if I go back to the iPhone now that everything is synced to it and go back to the Photos app, we can see we have much more than just Camera Roll there now. We've got Camera Roll still. These will be the photos we've taken since we've last synced and last taken all the photos off of Camera Roll. But we also have Photo Library, Scenery, and For iPhone. Scenery and For iPhone we can recognize as the two albums that we synced to the iPhone. So we can look in For iPhone and see those photos. And we look in Scenery and see those photos. Photo Library is simply everything in all the albums that we've synced or events or other things. You saw there were other options there where you can sync, say, the last 3 months worth of events, things like that. So everything taken from your Mac, all the photos from Scenery and For iPhone in this case, are under Photo Library. And they're not there twice. They're only there once. It's just two different ways of listing them. So we still have everything in Camera Roll and we have everything in the Photo Library, which is stuff from our Mac. So this shows a very common and simple method for most people to manage the photos on their iPhone. You take new photos, they go into the Camera Roll. Then you sync with iPhoto on your Mac to pull those photos from Camera Roll onto your Mac. Then you create albums in iPhoto and sync those back using iTunes to your iPhone so you have photos that you can show people. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. Go to that page. Underneath the video, you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.